Ba 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 ba, I'm loving it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Congratulations, you are being rescued.
What's going on, guys and gals, and welcome to Good Real Hunting, where we hunt for the good reels so you don't have to. It's your boy Brad, the Brett Man's right over here, and welcome to Star Wars Saturday. Once again, time for another Star Wars episode, and in today's video, we're going to be ranking all of the lightsaber battles from the live-action Star Wars Skywalker Saga. Bert, you pumped up or what?
I'm sorry, what did you say? I was just getting excited once you said lightsaber.
We're going to be ranking him, bad boy. Do you want to tell us how the what qualifies kind of as a lightsaber battle, just so people know what we're going to be getting into?
Okay. What qualifies for a lightsaber battle is, you know, when two lightsabers hit each other, but for a very extended period of time, like, not like a quick, like, little mini lightsaber battle. Like, we don't think that's very interesting at all, and it's just, they'll be at the bottom of most people's lists. So, the ones that we don't consider a Star Wars lightsaber battle is the Dagobah, the cave, with episode 5 between Luke and Vader, because that really honestly not really even happened. Just kind of like seeing the future for Luke Skywalker, so we do not count that one. And another one that we do not count as well is for episode 9 of The Rise of Skywalker, when Kylo Ren and Rey fight each other through the Force connection, because again, like, it was not very long of a fight that we didn't find, like, interesting enough to include it. And there was one more, too. What was that, Brad?
It was the first time Qui-Gon and Darth Maul meet in Tatooine. And reason being is just because, again, it's very just a small moment. All these, the three that we've mentioned here, are more plot devices than they are actual lightsaber battles, I think, just to kind of move the story forward. The rest of these are all pretty much any other time a lightsaber dukes it out with another one in the saga. And some of them are shorter than others. But then, yeah, we just wanted to, these didn't really feel right including. So we left them out.
Yeah, absolutely. And like, and you said the best, that Qui-Gon and Darth Maul fight at Tatooine was just a tease.
Mm-hmm.
And I really like that where you said it's just a tease. They build up for that ultimate fight, which I'm sure you will see later on in this video.
You may not, but you will. All right, dude, you were ready to get started with this thing?
Dude, I am so ready. My first three, are for the most part, are not like my favorite, but after that, all of them I really enjoyed. So I cannot wait to get this bad boy started.
Let's rock and roll. Do you want to start us with the worst of the worst?
All right, the worst of the worst, and just to let you all know, we are ranking 12 Star Wars lightsaber battles. Yes, it's that many.
Six times so, six, baby.
No, oh, yeah. Crap. Woo!
I messed all that math up.
Nah, you're good, dude. My number 12 is Episode 3, General Grievous versus Obi-Wan Kenobi. Or General Kenobi.
Hello there.
General Kenobi. If you want to get technical. Yeah, exactly. With this fight, it was cool to see Grievous with the four arms and all that, but he just knew the entire time that he just wasn't going to beat old Obi-Wan, old Ben Kenobi, you know? And it did look cool, just him, like... But, like, he wasn't really a... shut up. He wasn't really like a Jedi, though. So, like, totally outmatched. It didn't take that long for Obi-Wan to beat him. And that's why it's at my number 12.
That makes sense. My number 12 is actually going to be just the whole finale there of Attack of the Clones, where you have Anakin and Obi-Wan duking it out with Count Dooku, and then Yoda shows up. I'm just kind of including this all as one battle.
You're going to pay for all the Jedi that you killed today, Dooku.
And the reason being is just because, I mean, I just thought overall for a finale of a movie, for your epic freaking battle scene of the moment, the finale, you know what I mean? It was dog shit, just, you know, plain and simple. I thought it was, it wasn't very interesting. The whole thing starts with Anakin doing a little flippy spin thing to start battling it out. And the CGI is bad. And they used a lot of really strange cuts with Count Dooku just to kind of hide the stunt double they were using there for Christopher Lee. And there was no buildup to the Count Dooku at this point either, really. I mean, you kind of saw him like maybe 20 minutes prior to this, or I guess it was probably a bit, maybe 30, 40 minutes prior to this, but still, just there wasn't anything there. There was no emotional investment. It wasn't a satisfying conclusion to the movie. The only redeeming quality of this whole thing is when Yoda shows up and he takes his little green lightsaber out and he says, "Oh, much to learn you still have." And they have a little battle there. But then even when Yoda starts fighting, he's just doing a bunch of flips and it's CGI fest. And it just wasn't very nice. And again, this whole time, Obi-Wan was completely worthless in this. He's just laying over there in the grass, even though there wasn't any grass, but they made him look really strong in the first one against Darth Maul. And then this one, he just looked like trash.
Yeah. Dude, I absolutely like very, very good one. And I do not blame you. And at one point I did have that as my last battle as well. My number 11 is going to be, Darth Sidious versus the Jedi Masters from episode 3.
In the name of the Galactic Senate of the Republic, you're under arrest, Chancellor.
And the reason I kind of have it this low is just, yes, we're supposed to like establish that Darth Sidious is a very extremely powerful Sith Lord. And he took out those two Jedi Masters like that. But it was just really too quick for Jedi Masters, because freaking Jedi Masters been fighting for so many years. So you would think that they wouldn't get taken out that quickly. And then just like the fight itself, like between mainly him and Mace Windu, it was just okay. Like the scene wasn't mainly focused on that. It was mainly focused on the buildup for Anakin to turn to the dark side of the Force. They really didn't focus on the lightsaber battle more. And that's why I have it at 11.
Gotcha, dude. My number 11 is one you mentioned, Obi-Wan and Grievous, General Grievous, there from episode 3. And yes, pretty much same thing you just said. It was visually entertaining, and with the whole, you know, whatever you did earlier. And I think it had potential to be a really badass moment, but again, they used a lot of weird cuts and edits, and then Grievous ran away before it really got started.
All right, there you go. My number 10, you mentioned, and it's just that battle from episode 2, Attack of the Clones, of Anakin, Obi-Wan, and Yoda versus Count Dooku.
Powerful you have become, Dooku. The dark side I sense in you.
And you pretty much just said the words exactly. Very just disappointing after what they have given us from episode 1 with that final battle.
Surely you can do better.
And just to make Obi-Wan look weak, not a very wise move. Like,
Master Kenobi, you disappoint me.
Like, I would think that Obi-Wan had a better shot than Anakin, but they let it seem that Anakin had a better shot than Obi-Wan did. And I didn't agree with that. And just Yoda, it was cool him jumping around in the little green lightsaber, but as you said, a complete CGI fest of, hey, this is what we can do with CGI versus just really focusing on the battle.
Exactly. I feel you there. Okay, number 10 for me is Sidious versus Mace and his buddies. The one you just mentioned there from episode 3.
Are you threatening me, Master Jedi?
The Senate will decide your fate.
I am the Senate.
I love the reveal of Darth Sidious. I thought that was pretty badass. But then he does another weird flippy thing and flies over there, does a little spin from a video game, and then he slashes him out real quick. And my biggest disappointment with this was that freaking he and both him and Mace Windu are supposed to be two of the most powerful Jedi out there, or Force users out there. Mm-hmm. But their lightsaber battle was just, I mean, it was literally, you know, doing a little spin here and there, and it wasn't very good. There wasn't anything memorable about it until the end when Anakin comes in. That's it for me.
Yeah, just no fighting choreography at all. Like, just a simple walkthrough.
Yeah, you would think that would have been a little bit more epic, but anyway, let's get into the good stuff.
All right, this is the, like, from here on out, all of these I really enjoyed. My number 9 is, let's go back to episode 3 with Anakin and Obi-Wan versus Count Dooku when they were battling on that ship at the beginning.
You won't get away this time, Dooku.
Ten times better than the episode 2 fight, even though I didn't feel like that scene lasted as long as some episode 2, but they accomplished so much more about the fighting stuff was great, and the story of, like, just throwing a little sneak peek of Anakin using the dark side of the Force, and of course, you know, we got Palpatine there in this throne room, just shades of glory from episode 6, especially him going, do it, and just a very good fight scene, and more importantly, just good storytelling. I have it as my number 9.
I agree. Number 9 for me is also from episode 3, but we're talking Yoda and Sidious.
I hear a new apprentice you have, Emperor. Or should I call you Darth Sidious?
Yes, that's kind of the parallel fight going on with Anakin and Obi-Wan. Again, mostly because I thought this should have been a little bit more of a darker kind of vibe, but there's CGI everywhere, spinning little seats getting thrown around. And the lightsaber battle itself is pretty short. Like, a lot of it's the more compelling part of their battle is actually like the lightning stuff, the Force lightning and all that. Mm-hmm. I thought. But again, you just have Yoda doing a bunch of flips and stuff, which is it's fine and dandy, but it just it's kind of distracting to me. A lot of CGI and it wasn't that good. It was a little bit too over the top. Whereas, you know, you have Yoda here fighting for the fate of the galaxy, but you're really more focused on all these, you know, weird sensational things going on in the background. Mm-hmm. So that was it for me.
All righty. That's very good points. My number 8 is the episode 9 fight between Rey and Kylo Ren. I just didn't feel like the reason it's this low, like, to me, it should have been higher if J.J. Abrams did, you know, the whole trilogy and just developed the story a lot better. It got lost in the shuffle from episode 8 of kind of like the storytelling, the build up between that next fight. But it was cool. It was good. Cool fight choreography, just the water splashing everywhere and getting them wet and finding in that ocean, just really cool stuff. And that's pretty much all I really got to say about it. That's my number 8.
Yeah, man, I agree with you. That is actually my number 8 as well. It starts out in the throne room from the Death Star. I thought that was a good way of starting things out. And then you kind of move out the cinematography with the water coming down on Kylo when he's walking through with the lightsaber. That was really cool. I like that. And one thing that's notable here is the lack of music. We'll see this more on some of the higher things on the list, but I think that kind of adds tension. Now, sometimes music is fantastic, and we'll see that later as well. But in this particular case, I think the choice to not really have music going while they're duking it out, it adds a little bit of tension while Finn kind of watches helplessly from a distance. Mm-hmm. I think it's a good decision. And what I really liked about this one was the introduction of using the Force to stop the strikes of the lightsaber. I don't think I've ever really seen that before. I thought that was really cool. Again, it gets a little bit flippy at times, kind of like some prequel stuff, but it wasn't that bad. It wasn't very distracting. Overall, it was good, but it lacked the emotion that it needed to be higher on the list.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude, I absolutely agree. I totally forgot about stopping the lightsaber blade with the Force. That's never been done before. And that was really cool to introduce that idea. My number 7 is, let's go back to episode 3, Yoda versus Darth Sidious.
Not if anything to say about it, I have.
Like, you pretty much hit the nail on there. Like, there wasn't a whole lot of lightsaber battling. It was more just of who was just stronger of the Force. But the visuals of all the Force stuff and the lightsaber battle was just really, really well done. But I agree with you. What really holds it back is just it got way over the top too much. And it's just we weren't really focused on that fight just because they were going back and forth between that one and another one we'll mention later on in our list. So it kind of like it got distracted and got lost in the shuffle. If they would just separate into two different continuous scenes, it could have been higher for me.
Yeah, I think so. Because, yeah, I was more focused on the other one going on. Mm-hmm. And every time it shot, it came back to this one. I was kind of missing the other one. But either way, my number seven is going to be Obi-Wan and Anakin versus Dooku from part three, the one you mentioned earlier.
My powers have doubled since the last time we met, Count.
Good. Twice the pride, double the fall.
And just like you said, man, great parallels to Return of the Jedi, where they're in the where Sidious is watching it. You got the battle going on behind him, and then it ends with Anakin killing Dooku.
Do it.
He falls to the dark side here, whereas Luke at the end of Episode 6 defeats Darth Vader and then turns away from the dark side. I thought this was a nice contrast to that. It's a parallel, but you can see where Anakin failed or Luke succeeded later in life. So I thought that was cool. It was very, and the choreography and also all this stuff was fine, but it's really all about the story here. And it was a great way of starting the flick. The only negative I have for this one is the Obi-Wan again was kind of weak, and there was a really weird scene where he gets crushed by a balcony.
The effects of that were bad.
Yeah, that was one of the worst things I've ever seen. But either way, it was a good time and a great story set up here.
There you go. Let's see here. Now we are in our top six, okay? So let's start off with a real bang one. The one that started it all, my number six, episode four, Old Ben versus Old Vader.
When I left you, I was but the learner. Now I am the master.
Only a master of evil, Darth.
And yes, it wasn't the greatest fight in the world, but just that fight alone is just so iconic. And just what really just like changed not only just, you know, Star Wars, but just changed the world of cinema. Because I feel like that fight was what really like hit the numbers and just where Star Wars is today. Of just these two lightsabers, like red and blue, just and then just the sound effects and just again the storytelling of it goes, you're getting old. And he's like, strike me down and I'll be more powerful than you can possibly imagine. Just great lines from that. Yeah. And of course, Obi-Wan just sacrificing himself in order for Luke and his friends to be saved and to escape. And just pretty much mainly why, again, it's at number six. It's just so iconic. But the fight itself, just okay.
I agree, man. As a matter of fact, that's my number six as well.
You can't win, Darth. If you strike me down, I shall become more powerful than you can possibly imagine.
I didn't realize our lists are going to be so similar. But either way, yeah. For this, it's not about the fighting, ladies and gentlemen. It's about the buildup and the story. This whole time, you kind of get these hints of the history that Obi-Wan, Old Ben, Kenobi has with Darth Vader and stuff. And then they meet up, and it's a great scene where they kind of face each other. And you see, Darth's like, oh, when I left you, I was but the learner, but now I am the master. That was awesome. Yeah, you get a sense that Darth is kind of toying with Obi-Wan here. He's like, oh, your powers are weak, old man. And old Ben, dude, he knows that he can't compete physically with Darth Vader here. He knows he's going to lose the battle. He knows he's not going to win the battle. He's just going in to complete his task of protecting Luke. The task that he set out to do at the end of Revenge of the Sith, which is a fantastic arc and a great way to end this Obi-Wan character, at least physically for the time being. So I thought that was fantastic. It's a great story and it works really well with the prequels. But then he's got that freaking ace up his sleeve, dude. You strike me down and I'll become more powerful than you can ever imagine. And he gets struck down and he lives in the Force forever. The fight itself, again, the choreography is nothing to write home about, but the tension is there. The lack of music, like I discussed earlier, is there.
Yes.
The way the dozens of stormtroopers come run over and they're just watching, and it's just there's no music playing. it just gives you that sense that something bad's going to happen. And then the reaction you get from Mark Hamill and Luke after he gets struck down, fantastic stuff, man.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Again, it's just such an iconic, like, it's just a very important moment in Star Wars. So of course we have to rank it that high. My number five is going to be from Episode 7, The Force Awakens. First off, the imagery of that fight scene with the snow and all that, absolutely fantastic. And just it being dark too, so when the lightsabers light up, it like really shows. Just like the colorfulness of that. And then, of course, we all know Finn wasn't going to last long against Kylo Ren. We were just waiting. I feel like just for me, the first time I watched it, I was waiting for Mark Hamill and Luke Skywalker to come out of nowhere to save the day. But no, it's when Rey grabbed that, used the Force to get that lightsaber. I'm like, oh, now this is interesting. And then, like, she you could tell at the beginning, like, she didn't, like, know how to really fight, but as soon as Kylo Ren goes, I can show you the ways of the Force, and she goes, the Force, and that's when she calms down and really concentrates and gathers up the Force. That's when she learned how to fight through the Force and kicked Kylo Ren's ass. So it was just absolutely fantastic. The emotions were there too, because this happened literally after Solo died, or Han Solo died, and it was just great.
I agree, man. I'll talk about that one here in a minute. But my number five is actually going to be Anakin versus Obi-Wan from Revenge of the Sith. Mostly because it's this, as high as this is, it's the most disappointing for me of all the lightsaber battles.
I will do what I must.
This should have been the most, this is the most emotional battle of the series between two friends. Friendship's been building the whole time. And you can tell that, you know, they've developed a relationship over the freaking decades they've been together. And then freaking, you know, obviously Anakin goes to the dark side, and then, yeah, they duke it out. My favorite part about this, I think, is the score. It really adds to the emotions. This is where music is added in and it's used well. It gives you that epicness that comes with this, the freaking finale of the trilogy. It's awesome. I love the way you can see the anger on Anakin's face, and you can see the despair on Obi-Wan's face while they're fighting. It's awesome. You get a sense of tragedy with that, and it's just a way of capping everything off of with Anakin's turn to the dark side. I also love the blue on blue lightsaber choice. I thought that was fantastic. Mm-hmm. It was very unique at the time. Obviously, that's not something we see very often, is two blues going at it, and that represents the conflict of Anakin very well, I think. The choreography is great overall in this fight, but it gets way too over the top, and that's what holds it down a lot for me. I like Mustafar. I like the planet of Mustafar, but I do not like the way they used it here in the battle. They're swinging off of ropes. They're climbing up little ladders all while they're duking it out. They're freaking riding little floating droids down on the lava, like freaking your boy Kurt Russell in Escape from L.A. when he's surfing. Like, I was like, dude, come on now. They're freaking doing all this. Like, this thing, you don't need all this. You don't need it. Not for this battle. This is all emotions coming. This is the freaking, the story of these two characters is what needs to be told here. Not this freaking sensational battle floating on lava and all that. And that's what really, the CGI, all that, it's very distracting, where it should have just been focused in on the emotional side of things. So that's where it really loses it for me. They did a couple hand-to-hand things. I didn't think that stuff was done very well. But yeah, honestly, this thing should have been number one or number two in the franchise, but it just, with all the CGI and stuff, it gets dragged down to number five.
Brad, you're breaking my heart. You're going down a path I can't follow.
Oh!
You will try, but no, guys, you're going to hear my thoughts about it here later on. So let's see here. We are at number four, I believe. Is that correct?
We are.
All right. My number four is Episode 5 of The Empire Strikes Back, Darth Vader versus Luke Skywalker.
The Force is with you, young Skywalker. But you are not a Jedi yet.
Again, kind of the same thing a little bit. Luke Skywalker, like, he was training with Yoda. So he really, I didn't feel like during this time he figured out his fighting style. But that wasn't the most important thing here. The most important thing here was the storytelling. And the storytelling was on perb. One of the best storytelling lightsaber fights out of all of the lightsaber fights. And it was good for the most part. But again, Darth Vader was just toying with him most of the time. Just, you know, basic fighting styles. Nothing too dramatic, too crazy. Just the part that really bugs me more now that I actually think about it now than back then is Vader using the Force while having the lightsaber with both hands and just those boxes moving to hit Luke. That to me didn't age very well, but that's just a little nitpick. But again, just the storytelling and the whole developing to the point of Luke, I am your father. Just great stuff. So Empire Strikes Back as my number 4.
Interesting. This is where things are going to get shaken up a little bit. I think this is, our list has been very similar to this point, but they're changing a little bit. Number 4 for me is going to be Rey versus Kylo the first time in Force Awakens. For a lot of the reasons you just said, it was nice. This was the first time we had a grounded approach to the lightsaber battle with updated effects, without all this sensational stuff. And you said it. You said it best, my friend. The cinematography here was phenomenal, with the snow in the backdrop, the way the lightsabers were lit. Oh my gosh, it was awesome. But the buildup here is what really does it for me. It's showing how strong Kylo is throughout the movie, right? He's stopping lightsaber bolts. He's doing, or not lightsaber. He's starting laser bolts, blast, if you will. He's freaking probing people's minds. Like, he's a strong dude, but it's also showing the whole movie how strong Chewie's freaking bowcaster is. Like, there's stormtroopers flipping around every time they get hit by it. Like, it just blows people away. Kylo takes a shot from this thing just before this battle ensues, right when Han dies, which is also a great build up to this. It gives you a little bit of anger towards Kylo. Han's the best, right? Well, Kylo just killed him. We hate him now. Uh-oh. But he gets shot by the bowcaster that's been blowing people away the whole movie. He's bleeding. He's freaking hitting himself. He's weakened, right? That's a good storytelling thing. You see him duking it out with Finn there for a minute, which is fun. Again, like you said, we know that didn't last. But my favorite part of this is when Rey wakes up to Finn screaming in pain. And it's kind of blurry. And there's no music going on while they're fighting. And Finn's like screaming in pain, and Rey wakes up, and then you get the thing where Kylo's like, yeah, he tries to pull the lightsaber to him, but it skips him and goes down to freaking Rey, and then that score hits. Oh my gosh. Every time, goosebumps. It's freaking, the use of music there is beautiful. Fantastic. Very well done. Awesome stuff. I love that. And again, like you said earlier, with the lights and everything, fantastic. I love the way the lightsabers look like they have a little bit of weight to them in this one, whereas in the prequels they're just, you know, this one they're slugging them around. It feels more grounded. It feels more gritty. I love that. The only thing I don't really like about it is how Kylo ends up getting his ass kicked there at the end. But again, it's kind of played off with the bowcaster thing where he gets shot and he's weakened right now. I would have liked to see him a little bit maybe win this battle, though, to kind of build some intrigue for the next. But at the end of the day, I was wanting more when this was over. It left desire for more between these two characters. Unfortunately, the rest of it didn't play out as well. But this moment right here was fantastic.
Oh, awesome, man. Awesome. So let's see here. We are at our top 3. So my number 3 is Episode 6, The Return of the Jedi, Darth Vader versus Luke Skywalker. Again, it was just visually great. Like, for the effects back then, to still hold up today, just really speaks on just this particular scene. And just, it had it all. It had a lot better fight from, in my opinion, than Episode 5. And the storytelling was almost I would almost even say even stronger than episode 5, because we're just on the edge of our seats, like, oh, is Luke going to go to the dark side? Is the Emperor going to win? He's just sitting there just smiling the whole time going, good, good, like all that. And just, and the green lightsaber, be our first time seeing the green lightsaber was really awesome. And just, again, the imagery is just awesome. And just, and it was also our first introduction to the lightsaber being thrown by the ways of the Force. I thought that was really badass, too. And then just Darth Vader, you know, toying with Luke's emotions, going, sister. And then that's when Luke lost it and then just cut off Vader's hand. And then we get the awesome epic line of never. First, the lightsaber, I'll never turn to the dark side. You failed, Your Highness. I am a Jedi like my father before me. Just fantastic stuff.
Then we get the no. No. They added in line. They threw Darth Vader.
Talk about that shit. So go on to your number three, please.
I have the same number three.
If you will not turn to the dark side, then perhaps she will.
As you do. It's just like you said, man, it's full circle for the former farmer of Tatooine, learning the ways of the Force like his father, coming in. This time, they had a great battle in episode 5, but this time he's got confidence. He's doing flips and shit. It's not over the top flips, but like he's like, you know, it works well. It's showing how strong Luke is now. You can just see him projecting that confidence. It's the best choreography of the original trilogy, I believe. It's the most exciting, I think, of the original trilogy. And the backdrop of freaking the space battle, which was the best space battle in the original trilogy, maybe the whole franchise.
I'm sure we'll get to a top ranking on that list as well.
Most definitely. That backdrop, while they're duking it out, is awesome. And then just the way it kind of cuts to that too. Fantastic. Darth Sidious in the background. You can feel Luke's in a rough spot. He's freaking duking off against Vader. Sidious is watching. How can he win this? We don't know. We'll get into it. But then, yeah, like you said, man, when Darth tries to provoke him, and he says, sister, you have a twin sister. And he says, no, it goes to that wide shot with the score. Holy shit. Oh,
that
dude.
Score. Yes.
Again, the freaking goosebumps every time. Wide shot is panning. And they're just freaking, you can see the anger from Luke, and he just freaks, duh, duh, duh. The hand goes flying off. And then, like you said, he ends up freaking not turning at the end. Just going, yeah, it's fantastic, man. I love it. As a kid, this was my favorite of the trilogy for sure.
Oh, absolutely. And somebody actually brought this to my attention the other day, or just a meme I saw on a Star Wars Facebook page. Remember that scene where Luke is at the top of the stairs and Vader's at the bottom, and he wins, Obi-Wan has taught you well. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Okay. Imagine that. And then episode 3, it's over, Anakin. I have the high ground. So was Vader praising his son for Obi-Wan teaching him the secret arts of the high ground?
Yeah, that's exactly what it was, dude.
Yeah, dude. You've I thought that was. Before. Yeah, I never really imagined that until I saw that meme, so I thought that was hilarious. So, my number two, and this is tough, man, my one and two, this is like the toughest thing I had to argue with myself and the conflict within me, but I had to go with my gut, so my number two is episode 3, Anakin versus Obi-Wan Kenobi.
You are the chosen one! It was said that you would destroy the Sith, not join them.
To me, just all around together, the best of fighting, storytelling, imagery, all of it, all combined into one like ginormous scene. Just as you said, at best, the anger that comes out of Anakin and just the despair of Obi-Wan. Just great. Like, their facial expressions were awesome. The fine choreography was awesome. The imagery was awesome. I agree with you. And this is, I guess, what holds it back for me at the end of the day. Just the little over the top, like with the rope swinging and all that. I felt like wasn't necessary. They should just stick to the straight fighting and just in the focus on the story versus just relying on over the topness. Like, I know why they included it. It's the last of the prequel trilogy. They have to go big, like hit a home run. Like, but they could have done it without some of that over the topness. And then, of course, the emotion that comes out after, you know, I got the high ground sing, and that's when Obi-Wan chops Anakin up. Just all the sadness just comes out of Obi-Wan going, "You are the chosen one! It was destined that you would be destroying the Sith, not join them." I mean, like, and you feel so bad for Obi-Wan because he had do it to not only from like a master to student, but just from like a father to or like a brother to brother approach. Like, you could just, the emotions were there, man. So that's why it's my at my number two.
You were my brother, Anakin. Yeah, it was good.
Yeah. Just the emotions, man.
The emotional stuff was fantastic, man. And that's why it's so disappointing to see them doing all these flips and shit and rope climbing and swinging and flipping around lava droids and just all that stuff. Ah, it's so disappointing. If they would have just stuck to the story, it would have been the best, hands down. But anyway, we'll get into my number two. I digress. Number two for me is Duel of the Fates, dude. Qui-Gon and Obi-Wan versus Darth Maul.
We'll handle this.
This is, to me, is the best. It's the most exciting of all of them. I don't think it's the best. We'll get into that here in a minute. But it's the most, as far as choreography goes, it's the most fun to watch at the, when with all that stuff going on. And the buildup's good. The fact that you have, this is the first time, aside from earlier in the movie, the first time that they've seen a Sith. They've been in the shadows the whole time, and then the door opens up and it's Darth Maul, and then you get the freaking the score, dude, Duel of the Fates. You know, all that stuff. And they start freaking, he's like, "We'll handle this." And they light up. You got green sabers, you got blue sabers, you got red sabers, and you get the reveal of the freaking dual saber from Darth Maul. Fantastic, dude. Way to get you jacked up right here. This is it. Fantastic. But the fight itself, again, we'll get into it. The choreography, obviously perfect. The use of force and the hand-to-hand combat with the battle was cool, with Darth Maul opening doors and shit. That was cool. This is the first time in the saga that we see a Jedi and a Sith duking it out while they're both in their prime. So I think that's where you get all this excitement from. It's really cool. The backdrop, the setting and all that was sensational, sure, with the big power beams and whatnot going on, but it wasn't distracting. It made sense. It wasn't over the top like it was in episode three and whatnot. And again, the music, fantastic. Really adds to it. But then there towards the end, when the force doors are closing and stuff, and then right before Qui-Gon dies, it cuts to music. It gives you that sense of tension, that sense of dread, that sense of something bad's about to happen. And then once freaking Qui-Gon dies, holy shit, dude, the performance we get from Ewan McGregor, it's freaking phenomenal. You can see the anger in his eyes, and he comes in there, and that was always my favorite part as a kid, is the freaking, after Qui-Gon dies and Obi-Wan comes running in there just freaking full speed ahead, kicks Darth Maul's ass. Obviously he had a little bit of a slip up, but he ended up kicking ass. Great stuff, man. Intensity goes to 11 at that point, and it's fantastic. And again, I just love the whole thing there. It's awesome.
Sure, absolutely, man. And before we hit our number ones, which we're going to guess that you all know what our number ones is, I just want to quickly this ain't really a lightsaber battle, but I just feel like it just deserves to be like mentioned. That throne scene from episode 8, The Last Jedi. I just want to throw that in there. Like, I was disappointed with that movie. There wasn't a true lightsaber battle. That's what pissed me off about that movie. But that's for a future video down the road. But it's just that throne room scene, just visually astounding. And just the fight choreography and all that too. Just awesome stuff. And I just want to throw that out there real quick.
Dude, right you are, man. I'm glad you mentioned that. It does deserve at least a mention. Whether or not you like the movie, that's beside the point. This is one of my favorite moments in the franchise. With the way it's shot, the whole wide angle, freaking the contrast with the red, the people there and the blue lightsabers. It was fantastic. I love it.
Mm-hmm. Abso-freaking-lutely. So let's get down to business. Number one, as y'all probably already know with my list, is episode one, The Phantom Menace, Qui-Gon Jinn and Obi-Wan versus Darth Maul. And Brad pretty much said a lot of what I was going to say. But just for me, this was Phantom Menace was my introduction to Star Wars, just to the world of Star Wars. And it really, and that lightsaber fight really, really set the bar of what future lightsaber fights have to live up to. And I don't feel like we've had good ones with, like, again, Obi-Wan versus Anakin, Kylo versus Rey from episode 7, but just none of them have really lived up to that Duel of the Fates fight from episode 1. And as you said, Duel of the Fates, my absolute favorite score out of the entire franchise. Thus, it just sets the mood and atmosphere to that fight. And visually, it's stunning. The introduction to the double blade lightsaber was awesome. Every time I create a Star Wars character, I always chose the double blade lightsaber because of Darth Maul. And speaking of Darth Maul, how badass did he look? Like, such a unique look. His makeup and all that, fantastic. I instantly sold him as a badass. And as you said, the emotion from Obi-Wan when Qui-Gon Jinn died, just really just intensified that battle up to a whole nother level. And again, Obi-Wan had the high ground when he chopped off Darth Maul. So my number one, Phantom Menace, that will never change.
You know, Obi-Wan actually had the low ground this time, but he made it work.
He jumped over him, that's why I was saying the high ground. But
Anakin, yeah. That's interesting, because Anakin tried that exact same strategy many years down the road, but it didn't work out nearly as well for him.
But since Obi-Wan knew about the low ground, he knew how to counter it.
That's right.
The high ground.
That's where it all comes full circle for Obi-Wan. Great man. I love that one too. Yeah, that's obviously as a kid when that movie came out, I've watched that scene hundreds of times on the VHS. I'd fast forward the whole movie to that ending and just watch it, man. Mm-hmm. It was fantastic.
Obviously the highlight of that movie, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, most definitely. My number one is Luke versus Darth Vader from Empire Strikes Back. Again, this is all about the buildup, ladies and gentlemen. This is all about how badass Darth Vader was set up to be throughout this movie. Not only this movie, but the movie before it. Like his father before him. Anyway. the whole time, dude, Darth he destroyed old Ben in the first one. Easy peasy. No question. No problems. He's force choking bitches in this one. No problems. He's deflecting lasers with his hands in this one. This is his, he's built up to be this freaking invincible villain. He's one of the best villains of all time for a reason. Right. Uh-huh. And then you get the other side of that. You get Luke's story where he starts out as a farmer boy and he comes in and he's getting training. He's getting the trained by Yoda, in this one, Obi-Wan before old Ben, now Yoda. He's trained the whole time. He leaves training early because his friends are in trouble. We know that he is not ready for this battle. So that's what builds it up for me. He's like, okay, he's leaving training. They've told him he cannot defeat Darth Vader at this point, but at the same time, this is his last hurdle to become a Jedi. So that whole thing is great. He leaves training like, shit, Luke, this isn't going to be good for you. You're not going to do very well, I don't think, but that's what it is. But then you get when Luke arrives and he walks into the room, it's freaking the cinematography here is great. You get another wide shot, Luke walking up the stairs. You can tell in his performance, in Mark Hamill's performance, that he's not sure of himself. He's not confident in his abilities. He doesn't know what he's about to get himself into. He's trying something for the very first time. And that to me just adds a lot of tension because you're like, what's about to happen? He's not fully trained. He's here just because he has to be. And he's doing this way before he's ready to be doing it. So that adds a lot. And at the same time, on the other token, we know Darth is not trying to kill Luke, but he's trying to capture him, or he's trying to turn him to the dark side, essentially. Freeze him.
All too easy. Mm-hmm.
So that adds a little bit of intrigue too, because you're not getting Darth at his full potential at this point. So it's like, what, I mean, it's what's going to happen here. Okay. Luke puts up a good fight. It's interesting. Like, he does a pretty good job. And let me back up a minute. You get the yet. Yeah. You're not a Jedi yet. It's fantastic. Nice freaking, Luke puts up a pretty good fight. Again, Darth's not trying to kill him, but then, he ends up narking Darth down. They go down to the lower section there and start duking it out. Freaking Vader's throwing stuff at him with the Force. And he's like, he's way overmatched at this point, ladies and gentlemen, way overmatched. But then you have freaking you get the music that's playing, the slowed down Imperial March theme, while Luke's trying to deflect all this stuff and he's falling out the window. And then he gets to the freaking edge, man, the edge of the platform. There's nowhere for him to run. He's lost his damn hand. His damn hand is gone. He's like, his saber's gone. Everything's gone. He's going to lose this thing. He has no other options out. And that's when we get the reveal that Darth Vader is Luke's father. Holy shit. Music plays. What's going to happen? Oh, man. All this has led to this moment. We can see what happened now. And just freaking epic freaking moment. He ends up falling off the thing, setting up for the last act of the trilogy. And yeah, man, it's epic, man. Nothing beats this, in my opinion. Just with all that combined, it's just beautiful, man. Freaking beautiful,
dude. I couldn't agree more, man. But I wish I could make it higher. Maybe when we do the rewatches of the franchise, we can maybe move it up a couple more spots. But dude, I totally do not blame you. It's just classic stuff. So, ladies and gentlemen, that is our top. Lightsaber battles. We hope you enjoyed them.
Absolutely, dude. What are your thoughts on what they're thinking?
What are they thinking? You know what? Let's ask them. What did you all think about our lightsaber list? Do you agree with our list, or do you have a totally different list? Let us know in that comment section down below, and let's just get not only that discussion rolling, let's just grab our lightsabers out and let's just fight each other out in that comment section.
Yippee Ki Yay! And if you want to help us find the good reels, you can do so by finding us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Letterboxd, Spotify, and Apple Podcast. For the longer episodes, those links are going to be in the description.
And this lightsaber ranking will be on the podcast platform, so keep your eye on that. And be sure to like our video, subscribe, and share our channel. It really helps out the channel a lot when you do that. And of course, ring that bell, ding, 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 so you know when the next video is up, especially for Star Wars Saturdays.
Oh yeah, and we will. We will see you guys soon.
See you guys.
May the Force be with you.
May the Force be with you.
Before, at the end of Revenge of the Sith.
Yeah. Hello?
You know, that's actually my 8 as well. And again, it was shot very well. I love the cinematography here when Kylo's walking through the water and it's like dropping down and stuff. That was a good shot. And the way it kind of starts out there in the throne room from the Death Star, that was cool. The lack of music here is notable. I think it's pretty cool when they're fighting it out in the water spot.
Sorry to interrupt you. I was trying to do the timeout thing, but I could tell you were looking at your notes. Can you do that again? It really static bad.